Hi students, I welcome all of you from the teacher's desk again. Now I want to speak on education. How education is important in everyone's life. What role does education play in every man's life? I want to discuss over it. All of you know, all of you are familiar with the famous quotation that the education is the milk of tigers. Really, education is the milk which strengthens our ability, which strengthens our mind, which strengthens our memory. So education plays very important role in everyone's life. Again, I remember the famous quotation uttered by Karmavir Bhavrao Patil. He used to say, education is the key to the solution of all problems. If you have any problem and you want to come out of that problem, then what is essential? Education is essential. Without education, you cannot solve any problem. So education is the base. And that is why he realized that there is a poverty in Maharashtra. There is a sheer poverty in Maharashtra. There is ignorance in Maharashtra. And that is why in 1818, he established Rayat Shikshan Samstha and started schools and colleges to impart education to the people of Maharashtra. Because he knew only education will save the people in future. Friends, when I was in the school at the time, my uncle used to say two sentences. I remember, because at that time I was not able to grasp its meaning. I was not able to understand its meaning. But today I find these sentences are very important. My uncle, who is a lawyer and he is the first graduate from our family, he used to say, man does not become a man unless he completes graduation. And when I completed graduation at that time, I found that I have got a mental maturity. I have got a power of decision making. And so I realized that the sentence is really important. And the another sentence he used to say that till 40, man runs after money. Man runs after wealth. Man runs after property till 40. And when he crosses 40, he runs after the health. He takes care of health more than money. Today, I have realized the meaning of that sentence. So these two sentences are really worth to remember. Friends, my students, I want to give you an example from our history. From our history, what education can do in our society. What changes can education bring in our society? I want to give you an example. You know, in 1857, East India Company started 3 universities in India. For the first time, before that there were no universities in India. For the first time they started universities. Why did they start universities? Because they want to create skilled manpower. It was difficult for them to handle such a large country because Britishers were very few in number and we were 33 crores. So they wanted to produce skilled manpower here and they wanted to offer the jobs to Indians so that they will rule India for a long time. So they started 3 universities here. Their purpose was different. But what result did they get? That is more important. What happened? Our students, Indian students, got enrolled into the universities. They completed their graduation. And the survey was done. The survey was done. Out of 10 students, only 3 students accepted the job offered by British government. they become revenue official, they become clerk, they accepted the job. Remaining 7 people discarded the job of British government and they say that this country is ours. You are ruling us. You are exploiting us. Indians are being exploited. They are being ruled by the outsiders. So we will not accept your job. Instead, we will fight against you to get the independence. You know who was the first graduate from Mumbai University? Dadabhai Nauroji. What did he do? After completing graduation, he discarded the job offered by British government and published a paper, very famous paper, titled The Poverty and Un-British Rule of India. And he criticized the policies of British government. He raised the voice against the British government. This is the magic of higher education. I want to tell you, my students, this is the magic of higher education. Education makes us able to differentiate between what is good and what is bad. Education makes us able to differentiate between what is good and what is evil. Education makes us able to differentiate between what is justice and what is injustice. And when they got education, when they completed their graduation, then Indians knew that we are Indians. And we are being ruled, we are being exploited by the outsiders. So it is our first and prime duty to get independence, total independence from East India Company, from British people. So they fought against British government. This is the magic. So if you want to do something in your life, if you want to do something different from others, then you have to learn. You have to go to the schools and colleges. You must take degrees. More than that, you have to get more and more knowledge. Why? Have you thought over the conditions? Have you thought over the condition of a society? Why Tatas and Birlas and Nehrus and Gandhis are leading families in Maharashtra? Because their great grandfather was educated. And why we are inferior, do you know? Because our great-great-grandfather was not educated. So we are inferior. So we are living in a poverty. And why they are superior to us? Because education was there in their family. And that's why they accumulated a lot of wealth. That's why they established factories. That's why they entered into politics. And that's why they are ruling us. So go.